Hey, and welcome back to Let's Get Your Shift Together. I'm Coach Adriana, and today I'm going to be talking about smear campaigns versus you sharing the truth about what happened with the narcissist in your life. This is a topic that comes up a lot for survivors after they've experienced narcissistic abuse, and they're starting to feel a little bit empowered to start sharing their story, but then comes in that fear of, wait a minute, is this a smear campaign? Is it okay to talk about what happened? Or am I gossiping? So let's bust a few myths. The first thing we need to talk about is what exactly is a smear campaign. So this is when a narcissist starts spreading rumors about you in order to tarnish your reputation. They'll twist the truth, they'll exaggerate whatever flaws they decided you have and paint themselves as the victim. And the smear campaign usually happens when they're no longer able to control you. They will start trying to control how other people perceive you. And the goal of a smear campaign, at the end of the day, the goal of anything a narcissist does is to get supply. So what is supply? This is your emotional reaction, your time, your energy, your engagement in word salad conversations, you defending yourself about the lies that the narcissist is spreading about you. And during a smear campaign, if you're playing it right, you're not engaging, but they want you to engage. They want you to start defending yourself and explaining to their enablers and flying monkeys what the truth really is so that they'll report back to the narcissist and turn it into even more of a whole thing, because that is just what they do. They love creating chaos. They thrive in chaos. They live for chaos. And so if you're not participating in the smear campaign, which obviously is easier said than done, but really, you don't want to give the narcissist any supply during a smear campaign, they're going to be getting supply from whoever is participating in the smear campaign. So anybody who's listening to them, giving them pity for their victim story that they made up, whatever attention they're getting from a smear campaign is supply for them, whether it's from you freaking out or other people believing their lies. Now, you sharing your story is the complete opposite. Your goal is to heal, not to get supply, not to create chaos, not to start drama. And in some cases, maybe your goal is to share your story to help other people who have been through similar situations. That is not a smear campaign. And yeah, obviously, it's going to paint the narcissist in a negative light, but guess what? They did that to themselves. They get all the credit for that, not you, because you're sharing the truth of what you actually went through. Whereas the narcissist in a smear campaign is making things up and exaggerating things in order to support their agenda. And so when you're sharing your story, it's important to kind of decide who you're sharing your story with, right? Like, first of all, not everybody deserves to hear your story. Hearing your story is a privilege. And as you do the inner work and start healing from narcissistic abuse, you're gonna start valuing your time and your energy and your story and start being able to differentiate who deserves to hear your story, who is worthy of having this personal information about what you've been through. So do not share your story with the enablers and the flying monkeys, because they chose to be part of that toxic cycle. They are choosing to participate in the narcissist's drama and nonsense. And they are not safe people to share your story with. Because if you do, they're gonna report back to the narcissist. The narcissist is gonna accuse you of starting a smear campaign against them. And it's really done to confuse you and put you in a bamboozled emotional state, because anybody who's confused or in a bamboozled emotional state is easier to control. And remember, it's all about power and control with these people. So if you are in a situation where it is safe to share, you have people that you trust to share, or you're at that point where you've healed enough to start sharing your story and you want to share your story. I mean, it's not for everybody. It's not for the faint of heart. I can tell you from experience myself. But regardless, whatever your goal in sharing your story is, whether that's with a trusted friend or with a community of people who understand, that's not a smear campaign. And so if you have this fear that sharing your story is a smear campaign, let me tell you about guilt, shame, and fear, the three musketeers. I tell all my clients, these are the three emotions that narcissists will induce within their targets to make them easier to control. So fear, absolutely, is one of those emotions. Somebody who's afraid is easier to control. And keeping you in a state of fear is what the narcissist wants, because it keeps you small, it keeps you quiet, it keeps you sweeping the abuse under the rug as per the narcissist's expectations so that they can continue being abusive. So it's so important to process that fear. Allow yourself to feel that fear in your body. This is not something I can really get into in a video. That might be for another video in the future, but processing your emotions and journaling can be a really great way to do this. If you take my free quiz at the link in the description under this video, you will get the journaling instructions plus some journal prompts that will be relevant to you based on your results. But anyways, working through that fear, processing it, and releasing it will make space for clarity and help you feel empowered and confident in actually sharing your story. And you get to choose who hears your story, and who deserves to hear your story. Another aspect of sharing your story that can be really scary is the fear of how other people are going to perceive you sharing your story. And what you really want to keep in mind is that you have absolutely no control over what somebody else thinks, believes, or feels. You do not have that kind of power over other people, and that's a good thing. There will be people out there who are not going to understand or who are going to continue giving the narcissist the benefit of the doubt. And at the end of the day, their opinion is irrelevant. What matters is the truth, and the truth is the truth is the truth. And when you are empowered in the truth and you know what happened to you and you're at that point where you're not gaslighting yourself anymore, that is such a powerful place to be. And so if there is fear about how other people are going to perceive you, you want to absolutely work on processing that fear as well so you can release it and gain the clarity that their opinions don't matter. What matters is your truth and the fact that you even have the courage to share your story. And obviously, if it's not safe for you to share your story yet, then don't. I'm not saying in this video, like, willy-nilly share your story with the world. You know, that's everybody's situation is different, but this is really for people who are at that place where it is safe to share their story and they want to share their story, but they have that fear of, like, what if it's a smear campaign and what if other people think it's a smear campaign? At the end of the day, it's not a smear campaign. And of course, if you're going to be sharing your story online or something like that, like, you're not going to be identifying who the narcissist was. You're not going to be, like, blasting their name on social media or something like that, because that's obviously not a great idea. And that's what the narcissist would do, right? To, like, really tarnish your reputation. Like, you're just sharing what you've been through, and chances are it's going to help a lot of people. And obviously, if you're sharing your story with people who are in your inner circle, who know the narcissist, I mean, they're obviously going to know who the person is, but if they're, like, a genuine person who's in your life, who deserves to be in your life, they're going to give you the benefit of the doubt. They're not going to take the narcissist's side. And if they do, it's a really crappy way to find out who didn't really deserve a space in your life to begin with, but at least you'll know the truth. Being afraid to share your story when it's safe to share your story is really another subtle form of the narcissist still having control over you. And again, I sound like a broken record here, and I feel like I say this in most of my videos, but this is really why processing your emotions is such a critical part of the healing journey. Because once you get in touch with and process your emotions, you get clarity and confidence to take an action that would benefit you instead of keeping that emotion repressed and acting on it by taking an action or inaction that would benefit the narcissist. Processing your fear of speaking up is going to help you feel more confident and empowered in sharing your truth with the people who deserve to hear your story. Because don't forget, like I already mentioned, not everybody deserves to hear your story. I hope this video has been helpful. Don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel and turn on the notification bell so you don't miss any future videos when they get uploaded. See you next time.